All right, everybody, welcome to another episode of Sports Cards Live, recorded, because this is not live, this is recorded, and this is another episode of my eBay watch list ended items, where I go through items I was watching on eBay. Why was I watching them? What did I think of these items? Was I bidding? Maybe, maybe not. Let's see what we have. We got a lot to get through today. I like to keep these to about 20 minutes, so let's jump in and start with this Alexander Ovechkin Cup Auto Patch from 2013. I do love these base patch variation cards. I collect them without autos. This one has an auto. I didn't bid on this, but I think it's a really nice card. 10 produced on card auto. Pretty cool patch right there, as well as you can see as I blow it up a little bit. Sells for $788, 34 bids. Really nice card. Another Ovechkin auto patch is this 2016 Premier. This is a tribute back to the 02-03 Upper Deck Premier Collection rookies back in the Rick Nash, Jason Spezza RPA days. But this is an Ovechkin tribute. Really nice card, actually. Only 15 produced. This is numbered 1 of 15. The seller referred to it as the bookend because it's the number 1. I don't know if that, you know, is interesting for people or if they will pay more. I certainly won't pay more for a bookend card, but I do think it's cool regardless. $510, not a bad price compared to this one. I think both cards are equally nice, but this one's out of 10 and this one's out of 15. Maybe that's why the one out of 15 sold for a little bit less. We got some Bedards. We're following along, guys. Slab Sharks ran their Bedard special for consigners. And check this one out. This is the Outburst PSA 10. Sells for $5,200 Canadian or $37.75 US. So good to see. Those seem to be holding pretty steady. The Opeachy Bounty autograph out of 25. This card is raw. Sells for $2,328 Canadian or about $1,700 USD. Only 25 of these made. It's an on-card auto. It's a pretty good card. I mean, this is a pretty interesting Bedard rookie year or rookie card. So let's see what happens with them in the future. Only 25 of them out there. Next up, a Bedard PSA 10 Young Guns. Sells for $1,055 Canadian, $765 US, $766 USD. So these are definitely on the decline. And we'll see. I mean, last week we were around the 1,000 USD mark. Now we're dipping below $800. So we will continue to watch those. Alexi Lafreniere. This is a really nice card, guys. This is a limited logos from 2020, his rookie year. Short print limited logos out of 25 on card auto with a really nice patch right there. Sells for $739 US. I was actually impressed with that. Lafreniere, you know, he started the hobby hot, then he was cooled off for a few years. Now he had a great playoffs and a really good season. We'll see what's to come with Alexi Lafreniere as the next season comes our way here in October. My favorite player here, Teemu Selanne, 2014. This is similar to the Ovechkin we saw out of 15, but this is the silver out of 25. It is an all-star card. Look at his autograph. Just amazing. Number 25 of 25. That's one of those bookend cards. A nice patch. And I was very seriously considering bidding on this one right up until the final minute when I zoomed in on the card. And I just wasn't too crazy about that top left corner. More white showing than I'd like along the left edge as well. Other than that, though, it's a nice card. Man, for $230 Canadian dollars, maybe I should have bought it. I'll watch for another copy. If anyone has one, please let me know. I really do like the card. I'd like to grab one. And I just kind of got cold feet at the very last minute of that one. All right, guys. Next up is this Nathan McKinnon second year Emblems of Endorsement. I'm a fan of Emblems of Endorsement. I like Nathan McKinnon, and that's a really nice autograph. The patches are fine. They're both two colors. Some maroon would have been really nice in there. Sells for $636 Canadian. And the thing that I really love about second-year cards, especially from the Cup, is that you're going to see official NHL game memorabilia in it. And you can see that right here with this one. So great card. $636 Canadian, $462 USD. Seems like a good deal. Really nice card there. We have a 2020 McDavid Tribute Exquisite Patch Auto. This is a PSA 8 with a 10 on the auto. Nice three-color patch. Great autograph right there. This is one of those cards that was produced in Italy for Upper Deck. I'm not crazy about the way the serial number looks, but that's a minor quibble at best. You've got mesh. You've got stitching. Again, it's that 03 Exquisite design that's just oh so nice. Sells for 4,600 Canadian, 3,340 USD. You know, it's a, what is a fifth or sixth year card. These go for a lot of money because of that tribute lineage and equity in the Exquisite brand. And I'm not sure that I agree with the value, but it doesn't matter if I agree or not. That's what the hobby says, and that's what it sold for. So nice card sold by Savage Cards. I believe they are out of Montreal. All right, next up. Now, this is a great card, guys, but it's also kind of bad at the same time. Sold by my good friends at MC Sports Cards. Dual signature patches from 2010, the Cup of Wayne Gretzky and Mario Lemieux. Now, this card would have been super high on my watch list, guys. But look at these autographs. Look at the autograph. That thing is faded. It's terrible. Look at that autograph. Totally fading. Now, some people don't care. I care. I don't want any cards like this in my collection. I would not buy this card for any price. Give it to me $100. Fine, I'll take it, obviously. But I'm not paying market value on a card where the autographs are totally faded like that. Why are you putting these out on display, people? Sells for $1,850. If these autographs were in better shape, I could see this card selling for double the price. And as another just example of what's wrong with autograph grading, look at this. Beckett has awarded these autographs a 10. Well, how are these a 10 anymore? Autograph grading to me just does not make sense, especially when card autographs fade like these did. I'd love to own a copy. This is a card I want. If anyone has a copy with nice, bold, bright autographs, hit me up and let me know. I'd love to grab one. We had a PSA 2.5 Opici Gretzky rookie that sold in the last week. Sells for 1,176 Canadian or 854 USD. And this is a really nice copy for a 2.5. Look at the centering is great. The registration's pretty good. Oil drop a little bit high into the left. Of course, some corner creasing and bends, but you're going to get that. Outside of that, like, I don't really mind this at all. Centering is nice. Registration is very strong, not perfect, but strong. It's just this is a great copy of a low-grade Gretzky that I'm sure is going to make someone really happy, sold by our friends at Slab Sharks. Now, this is a fun card. This card is a dual signature patches Crosby Lemieux on card autos, game use patches numbered 17 to 25 from 2011, the Cup. And I just thought this was interesting. The guy had this listed at $4,000 with an opening bid. It didn't sell. He relisted it now at $4,000 with an $8,000 buy it now. He ended it, relisted it again. Let's check out the relisted card right here and see what's going on. $4,000, $8,000 again. Did he relist it again? Now he has not relisted it again. I don't know if it's sold, but I was watching it. Great card. Any card with these two guys is just worthy, especially with patches and autos. A Crosby Flair Showcase Hot Shots PSA 10. I love this card. Sells for $220 USD. Pretty cheap by my friend Justin Kramer at Kramer's Collectibles. Really fun card. I own a copy and I was watching it just to see what they were doing. Just wanted to see what these cards were doing. Same with this here. 05 SP Authentic Future Watch Auto rookie card, Alex Ovechkin at a $999. Great card. PSA 10's a great grade for it. Autograph is just brilliant. Look at how bright and bold that is. I love it. Numbered 150 of 999. A nice round number there. Card sells for $12,500 by Probstein Auction. Seems to be kind of right in where they have been selling for lately. So nothing surprising there, but something that I wanted to watch. And I really like the auto. Whoever won this card got a great example of the card. Here's a great dual auto, Gretzky, McDavid. I'm going to watch these every time one of these cards shows up. Sells for $3,750 Canadian, $2,720 USD on 28 bids. It's from Splendor 2017, Splendor number 1 of 36. So it's one of those bookends, if that matters to you at all. But, you know, you just can't go wrong. Great Gretzky on card auto, great McDavid on card auto. Nice images of the two players. McDavid is in his Team Canada uniform there, and Gretzky looks to be in a Los Angeles Kings uniform. Maybe it's a Team Canada because this is a Team Canada themed card. In any event, a great opportunity to have a copy or an autograph of both of these, you know, mega stars. $3,750 Canadian seems about right to me. I have no issue with that valuation. Here's McDavid's Upper Deck Ice rookie, the Ice Premier out of 99. These cards back in the late 2000s were among the most important rookie cards for any player, whether it was the Crosby or the Ovechkin, the Kane, the Taves, and the Carey Price. These were big cards. They're not as important as they once were, the Ice Premieres, but this McDavid BGS 10 pristine copy sells for $7,900 USD by Probstein. And again, 99 made. Great grade as far as grading goes, BGS 10. And I was watching just to see what this card would do. So $7,900, just that's over 10 grand Canadian, pretty healthy price for a card like that. Then we have his SP Authentic Future Watch Auto, similar to the Ovechkin from earlier. I like watching to see what these sell for. Numbered out of 999. Great autograph, really strong right there. 448 and 999 sells for 14,500 US. Again, keeping on top of those. And here's his Young Gun PSA 10, sells for $3,450 Canadian or $2,500 USD, right in line with where they've been. Not much movement there. I love these cards, guys. I just love the Opici Premier Diamond Rainbows. This is out of 75. It's from 2023 Opici. It's the second year they've done these Diamond Rainbows. I have the McDavid from the year before. I'd like to pick up the McDavid from this year as well. I don't need a graded copy. I'll be happy with a raw copy, and I'm going to continue to keep my eyes open for one. I just love these Diamond Rainbows. The first year they were out of 99 or 100, and this year they're out of 75. So I like that they're bringing down the print runs. These are cool, guys. Hot numbers. These are inspired by the hot numbers from basketball from the late 90s. But I'll tell you, I think these are nicer with a yellow background. This is an arena design, Gene McLeod design. I think they did a great job with them in 2022 Metal Universe Hockey. And I would like to grab a copy of this. I did not buy this. It sold for $151 US. Not bad by ComC. Not a bad price. I think that's a great deal, actually, personally. And here's the Jack Hughes from the same set, $42. Again, I was watching these to see where they are. I am interested in these cards. These are cards that I would like to own. And one day, maybe I'll buy myself a McDavid, maybe a Crosby, maybe a Jack Hughes to put in my collection. I'm not going to ever collect a whole set of things like this. There's too many players I don't care about. So I will make my own checklist from the main and pick one, two, three, or four players from it and pursue their cards. Here's another Jack Hughes Ultimate Collection Rookie Auto at a 99. Sells for $323 Canadian, $235 US. These Ultimate Autograph Rookies out of 99 might be some of the best value out there in the hobby. When you consider that their counterpart in SP Authentic out of 999, so like 10 times the print run, sells for a lot more. So this is sold by Slab Sharks. The card's raw, does 323 Canadian. I think that's a great deal. And look at that auto. Beautiful autograph, 76 and 99. Always great looking cards. Ultimate, it's been around a long time, but I don't know. I think there's just value in it. I personally do. I love these again. This is a 2021 Cup base patch autograph variation. I think they're great cards. I collect them without the autos, as some of you may know. I wasn't really going to buy this card, but I want to see what it would do. And if it would have stayed maybe low enough, maybe I throw a bid at it. It does 501 USD. I just love these cards. And this picture isn't a great image of it, but the autograph is also, you know, it's over a lot of the blue hockey pants there. So it's hard to see, but still a really cool card. And one that I just was interested to see what it was going to sell for. Now, these gold outburst 101s from 2023 Upper Deck are really cool. I managed to pick one up at the Montreal show. I picked up the Braden Point 101. This is the Robert Thomas. And again, I'm just going to watch a lot of these outburst golds to see what they sell for. And I might try and pick up a few for myself because they're really awesome. It's the first year of them, which I really like. The 101 stamp's pretty cool right there on the jersey. You can see it sells for $255 USD for he's not a common, but you know, he's definitely not a superstar. So we'll see what else comes in future listings on eBay for other gold outbursts. This is a cool card. This is from In the Game Superlative, which was a high-end product that came out for a few years. And 2012 was, I think, maybe the last year of it. This is Shea Weber from his junior team, the Kelowna Rockets, I believe. And this is just a neat patch card. I forget the name of this character here, the Ogopogo. I think he's called the Ogopogo, who's maybe known to swim in Lake Okanagan, which is where Kelowna is located, on Lake Okanagan in British Columbia, Canada. Anyway, a really cool patch card, game used junior card, sells for $374 US, and I just want to see what it was going to sell for. I was not a player on this card. Kale McCarr Ultimate Collection Shield Patch Auto, one of one from 2022 Ultimate. Really cool looking card, important card, great player. Sells for $3,000. Okay. Well, so you think with 25 bids, but if you go above, it's been relisted. So those bids didn't. Now it's listed as we sit for $3,000 US or best offer. So what happened here? Here's the original listing, 26 bids, $3,000, doesn't get paid. Ends on June the 9th. We have bids coming in up until June the 1st, then no further bids came in. Now let's show automatic bids. 472 is the winner. The bidder with feedback, 472 is the winner. Show automatic bids, and you can see all these bids by 472. 2550, 2700, 2850, 3000. Might have been more, not sure. We come down more. 2450, 2375. So 472 and 319 are kind of having a bit of a bidding war here. It seems like, although 319, no, I got to take the back. 319 is chipping away at 472, who was proxy bidding in the middle, and 319 keeps on chipping away, but 319 doesn't win. 472 wins and then doesn't pay. I don't know. I don't know if there's something fishy, if there's shill bidding going on here, and also why were there no bids in the last 8 days of the auction? Is it because it was too high priced? Did the shill bid ruin the auction because no one else wanted to bid higher? Maybe that's what happened. I mean, the card was relisted, so it obviously wasn't paid for. So think what you will. All right. 97 Upper Deck game jersey, Jerome McGinley. This is the second year of Upper Deck game used jerseys. I love these. I collect the first and second year. I have this card already. Just wanted to see what it was going to sell for in raw. 87 Canadian, 64 USD. Really cool card. And it's a young Jerome right there. Hey, his son's about to get drafted. And that brings us to this 79 OPG Wayne Gretzky authentic card with a PSA DNA cert on the auto. But look at this auto. It's just a terrible autograph. Terrible autograph. And now listen, nothing against anybody. Maybe that's Wayne Gretzky's fault. I don't know. There seems to be wax remnant residue still on the card. And maybe that's why it gets all blotchy in that. But in any event, it sells for $2,125 USD by Probstein. Autograph looks good to me. I'm no expert on Gretzky autos, though. In any event, I just wish that autograph was nicer. It would have been a way better specimen. Here's this card. I really wanted to buy this card. 2008 Guy Lafleur, honorable numbers out of 10. Guy Lafleur, you know, he played in the 70s and the 80s, mostly the 70s. He's a Stanley Cup winner, one of the greatest players of all time. This card is out of 10. You got two color Montreal Canadian patches, a great autograph. He is since deceased. He's no longer with us. I did make an offer on this. I was denied. It ends up selling something under $14.99 Canadian. Let's actually do this. All right, let's go to Card Ladder and search for this card. And let's see what it sold for. Is this going to give it to us? It is going to give it to us. Looks like it ends up selling for $725 US, which is going to be right around 1,000 Canadian, I'm guessing. While they were asking 1,500 Canadian, they end up taking about $1,000. Great card. Guy Lafleur does not have a lot of auto patches in the cup. All right, here's a hot numbers. We saw the McDavid and we saw the Jack Hughes earlier. This is the original from 95 Flair. The hot numbers, Michael Jordan, PSA 10, sells for $2,100 US by Hoodies. I was really surprised with how low it sold. With the way Jordan cards are going, I expected this to sell for a lot more, but maybe I'm just out of touch. Keeping on going, we have a Kaboom Steph Curry from 2023. Kaboom Gold, numbered out of 10, PSA 8, sells for $26,100 by Probstein, guys. I'm just super kind of blown away by how much a 15th year Steph Curry card would sell for. But that Kaboom brand, the gold, you put those two things together and big money ensues here. Only 10 copies made, $26,100 USD. Staying on the basketball theme, here's a gorgeous Magic Johnson Noble Nameplates patch card out of 31, sold by MC Sports Cards. Let's see what this sold for. In any event, sells for something under $3,199 US dollars. This is really cool. This is a Dennis Rodman 98 Metal Universe. This is a painting card painted on a base card by the Currency Project. These guys do really cool work. I do own one of their cards from a few years ago. I wanted to buy this card. I think it's just a really nice production by the Currency Project. Watch these guys. They offer one card at a time, and they're just really cool, doing really cool card art. We had a Ray Allen Essential Credentials. This isn't an HGA 8.5 holder. Who cares about the holder in this case? You want the card. Sells for $11.25 US. I love Ray Allen. I was a fan of Ray Allen, and I love Essential Credentials. I just want to see what it was going to sell for. I'm not really in the market to be buying high-end basketball right now, but or high-end, you know, 90s Ray Allens. If it's Shaq or MJ, it's a different story. But in any event, I wanted to just watch the card, see what it sells for. And this does $11.25. And the Kobe High Voltage 500, the High Voltage 500, which is a really tough parallel of the High Voltage, sells for $5,976 US on 55 bids, BGS8. These are just awesome cards. There's the serial number. We see them every so often, whether it's on the PWCC Weekly or Premier or with MC Sports Cards. We see these cards every so often, different players. They're beautiful. They came out of cheap packs, and now they are worth a lot of money. $59.76 on the Kobe. Tim Duncan, another major, major 90s basketball insert slash parallel. This is the Molten Metal Titanium. It's the gold version. It's numbered out of 40 right there. This is graded a PSA 3, super low grade, must be just surface, and there's some crimping, it looks like, on the right side, the right edge, top right corner damage. But despite that, this is an awesome card. And you know what? These are like the Michael Jordan, this is probably $250,000. Meanwhile, the Tim Duncan in low grade sells for $4,806. I think that's just really a great card at a good price. Ken Griffey Jr., auto patch. You just cannot go wrong with something like this. Look at the patch. Look at the on-card auto. Tops Dynasty sells for $38.50 US. Man, would I love to have one of these. I was watching this one out of curiosity. Same with this. You know, Kyrie Irving, Logo Man 101 from 2017, Flawless, sells for $11,274. You know, what is with him on the Celtics right now, two games away from the championship? I wanted to see what this card would do. 11,274, not bad for a guy who's, you know, not named Tatum, not named Luke on the other team. I was curious what it would sell for. And then finally, last card of the show tonight, guys, Michael Jordan Jambalaya from 97, the original Jambalaya. This is an authentic holder, sells for $12,500 USD. You look at the card, you think, wow, this is really nice. Why wouldn't they grade it? Look at this. It looks perfect on the front. Centering is awesome. I mean, it's tough to tell on surface, but looks awesome. Then you look at the back, though, and look at this. Paper loss on the top, severe on the bottom. So some paper loss on the back of this card that brought the grade all the way down, or didn't bring the grade down, but caused the owner to only slab it as authentic and not ask for a grade. I'd prefer a grade still, but boy, that front is just brilliant. And even with the back, as rough as it is, still sells for $12,500. Well, guys, that's it. That's what I had on my watch list. What I'm doing is I'm building up my watch list during the week, saving them until I do the episode. Then I'm deleting them from my watch list and we'll build them up again. Hopefully we have enough items that I was interested in watching on my watch list. I didn't buy anything in the last 7 days on eBay. I'll keep you guys apprised of my purchases as well. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Hope you enjoyed this. Let me know what you think down below. Did I make any mistakes? Did I speak out of turn on any of these cards? What do you think of those faded autographs? That dual Gretzky-Lemieux, the Gretzky rookie. What'd you think of those? I mean, does autograph grading make sense? Tell me what you think below, guys. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you again next time.